be entrepreneurial and do it. It is not once you graduate from college or once you finish this or that, then you can venture into those things. Do them when you're a teen. Do stuff when you're a teen. If you have an idea, run it by people that are successful in business or in entrepreneurship. Discuss your idea with them, refine it, see how you can get started. And you don't always think you need to have big investment capital to start something. All you need is a good idea and work ethic, and you can start something. And you can be huge. You can be huge. That's what the Ummah needs. The Ummah needs creative entrepreneurs. The few that we have, the few entrepreneurs that we have are driving, they're actually shaping the direction of the community. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah, we have enough doctors. We have enough programmers. Don't be a programmer to work at a company. Start your own firm, make the next most amazing, most downloaded app. You should do that. That's what you guys should be. And when we do that, I tell Muslims to do this. You know why? Because we have to understand the new language of power in the world is economics. We have to understand that. Right now, we're struggling to even pay for our masajid in America. We are some of the most well-off Muslims in the planet. And we have a hard time paying off. We don't even have an economically sustainable model for our own masajid, our own schools. That's because we haven't thought big enough. We have to learn to start thinking big. And we have to develop a work ethic for it. But the barakah, the blessings in that creative work will come when the foundation I talked about is already there. If your salawat are good, your worship is solid, your knowledge is increasing, and you're serving humanity, your mind will be in the right place, and Allah will put barakah in your business. Allah will put barakah in your entrepreneurial venture. And He will not let you become a materialist and a greedy capitalist. He'll make you a socially responsible entrepreneur that will make this country and inshallah the world a better place. And we're not just here to serve the ummah. We're here to fix the world. You have to think that big. You have to aim that high. Don't shortchange yourself. Don't underestimate yourself. And even though we are just at the end of the day slaves of Allah, and we are the lowest before Him, the closest we are to Allah is when we put ourselves the lowest on the ground. That's our humility to Allah. But when Allah gives you a gift, and Allah gives you intelligence, and Allah gives you an educational opportunity, and Allah gives you a creative idea, and Allah gifts you with a talent, and you say, I'm way too humble to exercise my talent, then that is not humility, that is ingratitude. That is ingratitude. You have to exercise your talents. You have to make the most of yourself. قُلْ كُلٌّ يَعْمَلُ عَلَى شَاكِلَتِهِ Tell them everybody should work in accordance with their predisposition. Every one of you has a predisposition. You have a talent. You're good at something. Find out what that is and find out how you're going to use it to its maximum potential so you become a contributor to the world, not a consumer. Everybody else, their own goals, their own bank account, their own savings, their own fashion. Oh, man, one day I'm going to drive that car. I'm going to have that kind of house. That's all they think about. We're going to say, one day I'm going to make people come out of poverty in this neighborhood. One day I'm going to transform the school systems in my town. I'm going to make the city a different place than it is now. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to leave you. I know I have time. My time's up. But I want to leave you with a really cool story. I was really floored and inspired by it. Last week, I met, 2 weeks ago actually, I met a brother in New Jersey at the American Muslim Consumer Conference. He's the mayor of Bergen County, New Jersey. And the mayor of Bergen County, New Jersey, alhamdulillah, is a Muslim fellow, young man, who actually prays Fajr every morning at the masjid. Alhamdulillah. And he, you know, people at the masjid, of course, treat him like garbage because we're Muslims. But let me tell you something about him. I said, how did you win the election? I mean, you're clearly brown, and you're openly super Muslim. He doesn't hide it. That he's religious and he's Muslim and he's conservative, et cetera, et cetera. And it's a majority, almost 90% is Jewish population in that county. It's a very heavy Jewish population. There's more synagogues there than the rest of New Jersey. So how did you win the election? He goes, I didn't win, I went twice. I was like, oh, sorry. First time 56%, second time 85% of the vote. I said, how did you do that? He said, well, I went into public service with the belief that I'm here to serve the public, my public. I have political views about Gaza. I have political views about, you know, drone strikes. I have those views, and I openly state them, but I also openly state none of my political views matter when I am serving public office, because I am here to serve you people. So I go to the synagogues, and I go to the businesses, and I go to the stores, and I go to the offices without the reporters, without a press release. I just walk in and I say, hey, how's it going? I'm the mayor of this town. How can I make your life better? I'm just here to serve, because I want to see the city improve. And I'm just going to serve. And people see that for what it is, and I get the vote. I say, man, that is awesome. That's what a Muslim is supposed to be like. Ihsan, you know? I'm going to do something, and I'm going to do it better than anybody else has done it. And I'm going to let my work speak for itself. No banner, no advertising campaign. He doesn't have to put up a whole advertising campaign that I'm a Muslim, but I'm not crazy. Please vote for me. I'm not like the other crazy guys. I wasn't, you know, one of the 11 or whatever, one of the 19. I'm not one of those guys. He doesn't have to do that. He lets his work speak for himself. It's high time the Muslims stop crying that we're being stereotyped against. People say assume things about us. They make fun of us. They say offensive things about us. They make films about us. It's high time now that our work speaks for itself. Our contribution to society speaks for itself. That will shut everybody else up better than anything else. Let the actions speak, and the words will be silenced themselves. I pray that you are the generation that makes us look back and say, mashallah, we did something right. We raised a generation that Allah put barakah in, and they were the entrepreneurs, and they were the pioneers of the ummah to come. Think big of yourselves and don't live petty lives. And when you get a sense of vision and direction in your young age, then your youth will be spent exhausting those energies in the right direction. Otherwise, you'll be people of PlayStation 3s and Xbox 360s and Facebooks and Twitter, and that's all your life will amount to. You won't be much after that. You'll just be a consumer. You're the biggest thing you're looking forward to is the next upgrade to the iPhone. Get over it. There's bigger things in life. You're here to do more important things. Barakallahu li wa lakum, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.